those nasty six-legged creatures that none of us love, especially my wife. She does not love aphids. There's a lot of us that think that if we grow indoors, we'll never get pests. That's really a fallacy, misnomer, because we go in and out of our house, we open doors, we open windows, we have animals that bring things in from the outdoors. Anytime we go into spring and the full desert is in bloom, like here in Arizona, you know, we have orange trees, all the shrubs and things are blooming, we get lots of pests. Now there's some beneficial pests as well, lacewings and ladybugs that are there too, colomanes. I mean, so there's a lot of healthy pests as well, but we all have this idea that if we grow indoors, we never have pests. That's not true. We will get bugs, but I'm going to give you some hints, some great hints of what you can do to eliminate those and have bug-free salads. Okay, so there's a resource that's been developed at towergardenstore.com. It's actually natural organic pest control guidelines for a tower garden. So these are tried and true measures that have been developed for us to use and be successful in maintaining our healthy towers pest-free. So I've got a few of these products that we carry and we sell out of the True Garden website. And the one that we use a lot of is neem oil. And again, it's made from the neem bean, so it's a botanical. You always want to spray these things on when the lights are either off, if you're growing indoors, or we want to spray at sun up or sun down so we don't burn our plants and kill beneficial insects too. So we typically spray at sundown here at the farm, and that way we don't kill those beneficial insects. They've already gone back home, and then we can actually be successful. So we have little spray bottles. You know, again, these are concentrates. You only want to use a half a teaspoon in like this 16-ounce spray bottle. Give it a good shake. You know, put 2-3 drops of dish soap in there. If you got Ivory or Dawn or Melaleuca, just something non-perfume. Shake that together and really saturate that leaf. And again, on our sheet, it talks about how to mix these things up on there as well. It's a great resource. Go to towergardenstore.com for that. So when I get questions about how do I control pests or bugs in my tower, I really tell people we want to keep our produce nice and manicured. You know, the herbs, you know, keep them cut back, keep them nice and rounded. Like this basil here is a little bit overgrown. So again, we want to keep it nice and well groomed. And so cutting off our tower, you know, once a week, keeping everything in check will be really beneficial, because then this waxy cuticle layer on our produce doesn't break down, allowing the bugs to enter. Plus, if we're looking at our tower and doing that on a weekly basis, then we're looking for bugs as well. So as soon as we see something, we can be right on top of it before it gets out of hand. So our first line of defense is always going to be soap and water with neem oil. Or if you're outdoors, the easiest way to take care of pests out there, because it takes a few days for bugs to really reproduce, you can actually take your water hose and just gently give it a shower in the morning. Do that a couple, 2-3 times a week while you're outside. Just rinse your tower off gently and you're going to see whatever's landed on it wash off it. And then on those other days, then you can give it, you know, hit it with some soap and water or neem oil. If you're just going to use some soap and water, just use a couple, 2-3 drops in a 16-ounce spray bottle. Don't be excessive. You can use essential oils. Again, you want to be less is more. Remember, those essential oils are very potent. So just 1 or 2 drops is more than sufficient. And again, spraying either when the lights are off or at sundown. So I want to talk a little bit about when we're having issues with other soft-bodied insects, be it aphids or whatever. Again, we have a concentrate. These are all OMRI approved for organic farming. These are concentrates designed just for our home towers. And so what we'll do is it talks about how to use them as well. So again, just a half a teaspoon in a 16-ounce spray bottle. Again, put some 2-3 drops of soap in there with it, shake it up in your spray bottle, and then douse the leaves, and you're all set to go. We also carry another product that helps with caterpillars. Again, it's called Thuricide. It's OMRI approved as well. So when we're growing our tomatoes and also we see our leaves disappearing before our very eyes, you can go and look at sundown, look on those leaves, you're gonna find a nice little caterpillar there. Some of us like them. I just toss them to the chickens. The neighbors have chickens, so the chickens love them and fight over them. But again, you wanna give this a good shake and, you know, half a teaspoon in here and spray those leaves. And it's a natural bacteria. Thuricide is a natural bacteria. Doesn't affect us, but when the caterpillars eat that leaf after this is dried, it just actually kills them and they fall off and you'll find them on the top of your tower. So a real simple thing to use for killing your caterpillars. Wanted to talk a little bit about powdery mildew. There's different things you can do for powdery mildew. It's that white substance that you'll get on your leaves. You can use baking soda. There's a recipe to use like a little baking soda on the internet. If that doesn't work, we have some liquid copper, which is great. You just have to be careful with this because it can stain your tower. So you're gonna wanna drape it with a cloth or paper towel so when you spray it, but this will take care of it as well. So when the baking soda doesn't work, or we use sodium bicarb here, some mill stop on the commercial level, you can use this. So we've been talking about how we take care of insects and things. We've now created a tower cover kit, insect barrier. It's just made out of wedding veil, that tool stuff that you can buy like at Walmart and different places like that. But we designed it to where it drapes over your tower and you've got your tomato cage on there, some clothespins so you can clip it on. And that way you can just leave it on day and night and keep those little insects, pests off your tower. So a very simple solution. It's not expensive at all. And again, just another way to keep your towers bug free. So we have several organic solutions and natural ways to keep your towers bug free. We're excited about offering these things to you. Just have fun. Keep it simple, keep it fun. Keep your tower nice and manicured, and you'll have bug-free growing year-round.